Welcome to Phuket News TV. I'm Hayden Rhodes, the club manager of RPM Health Club. And in just a moment, I'm going to be interviewing the master Mr. Universe and master world champion. He's 71 years of age and may hold the elixir of youth, the fountain of youth that we're all looking for. See what he has to say next.
Hi, Hayden.
Hey, so tell us, how did you get started and why you got started into bodybuilding?
Well, originally I was a 14-year-old skinny kid at school, younger than the other kids in my class. I got bullied. I saw an advertisement, buy a barbell set, which I did. And I worked out like a maniac for 2 years and 9 months and put on about, 70 pounds, which is about over 30 kilos of body weight.
And that was when you were young?
When I was young, from 14 to 17.
And the kids were billing you at school?
Well, I started entering a few bodybuilding contests. Then I went to university, got involved in university and in business, and I stopped bodybuilding for 40 years, became a tennis player. Gradually my hips started to go, so I played less tennis and started a little bit of bodybuilding and got back into bodybuilding. Finally had a hip replacement, that was the end of my tennis, and focused on bodybuilding for the last several years very seriously and been competing in the world championships and things like that. So I had a coach and, you know, got involved and got serious.
So just let me get this right, you started when you were 14, you 14. Dropped it for like
17.
You dropped it for 40 years.
Never touched a weight for 40 years. In fact, I hold the record because I competed when I was 17 and never competed again for 51 years. And my next competition was the World Championships after 51 years.
Amazing. And did you win that,
no,
Mr. World?
No, I didn't win that one, but I've been winning this year.
But currently you are Mr. World.
I won the World Championships. I won two Mr. Universe, Mr. Europe this year, and Grand Prix de France IFBB Open as well this year. I've won 5 competitions this year.
And so this scare of osteoporosis and the hip fracture, did that scare you?
What happens, actually, the best thing to avoid osteoporosis is to do weight resistance training. Because the weights, you know, put your muscles pull on the tendons pull on the bones, makes the bones strong, and you'll never get osteoporosis if you do resistance training.
Beautiful. And now, what about for the people out there that have never done weights before? They're scared of getting big, they don't want to get big, but they don't want to get osteoporosis. Well, I mean, what's your training and what's the average person's training?
They don't have to worry about that. To get big, you've got to train a lot, you've got to eat a lot. It takes years. What you see here is years and years of hard work. For the average person, I would suggest hiring a personal trainer, getting started with a personal trainer, train 3 times a week, get some decent amount of sleep, eat properly, and your trainers will be able to tell you how to eat. You need protein, your muscles need protein, you need a certain amount of carbohydrates. But the eating is just as important as the working out. Because if you worked out all the time, you never ate properly, you wouldn't look like anything.
Good. Now, you've certainly got some secrets, and you've said this has taken a long time to get to the size and the shape that you're in, and you're in great shape. What are some of the secrets that people out there can use to just improve their own physique, improve their own lifestyle, without, you know, getting too big or training every day?
Well, the first thing to do is to eat healthily. The first thing to do is you cut out the soft drinks, the sodas, the sugar. Sugar is a killer. Stop eating that. Eat less bread. Focus on eating vegetables, a lot of vegetables. You can eat protein, you can eat fish, meat, chicken, vegetables, but cut back on the white rice, not too much white rice, especially at night. If you're eating carbohydrates, eat them for breakfast, eat them for lunch. If you want to lose weight, stay in shape, don't eat too many carbohydrates at night. Vegetables are great, you can eat a lot of vegetables and get healthy, but cut out the sugar. That's my main message, would be no sugar at all in anything.
No sugar. Now, what about training secrets? Because a lot of people these days don't have much time.
Right.
They might not be able to have access to a beautiful gym. They're stressed out. Any secrets to do with training
With training, firstly, there's certain exercises you can do at home. You can do push-ups, you can do pull-ups, you can do certain things at home that will develop your muscles. You can get starting with a personal trainer in a gym. A good personal trainer will show you a short exercise regime, 45 minutes, 1 hour. You can work your whole body if necessary, 3 times a week. Look, it's much easier to spare 3 hours a week rather than, you know, 3 times or 1 hour 3 times a week than to spend 24 hours a day in your grave. underground. So, you know, people who say they're too busy. That's nonsense. Nobody's too busy. Your health is the most important single thing that you can have. Without health, you've got nothing. Doesn't matter how much money you've got, how many girlfriends or boyfriends you've got. If you're not healthy, you can't enjoy a thing. So the main focus is to focus on health.
Good.
Get healthy, eat healthily, work out. Your body needs resistance training. You need a certain amount of cardio. And you'll live longer, you'll feel better, you'll be stronger, you'll have a greater libido. It'll be fantastic.
So for the 40 years where you weren't training, were you still staying active? Did you still eat healthy? So you had 40 years of good base before you started lifting at 60?
I had 40 years of a lot of tennis, at least 2 hours a day on average, maybe sometimes more, but I ate too much and I was actually overweight, although I played all at singles. And I played top class tennis, but I was still overweight. And then I was very fortunate about 16 years ago, I met Dr. Atkins. His name might not be known here, but the Atkins diet, and he got me onto his diet, which included eating more protein and less carbohydrates. So I said, I can't waste the protein. I started going to gym after tennis. So I started working out a little, and that really got me back into it. And now I'm almost 72, and I look much better than I looked at 70, at 60, at 50. I'm in the best shape of my life. And I feel great.
Now, we know Atkins passed away, and there were some contradictions with the diet. What happened after that?
What happened with Atkins was he slipped on the ice in New York, right outside his office. Mm. His feet shot forward on an icy sidewalk in April of 1 year, and he cracked his head on the sidewalk and died about 3 or 4 days later. I knew him personally. We were very good friends. Mm. It was very sad. It was tragic.
Do you still follow his regime, or have
more bodybuilding in that. I've got to eat protein. You know, as a bodybuilder, your body doesn't store protein. So you have to replenish protein every 3 hours. Not too much, as much as your body can use, but you have to have small amounts of protein every 3 hours if you really want to build your muscles. And so now I eat more as a bodybuilder, and I have my coach really does my diet more than anything else. It's more important. I know the exercises, but the diet is what I follow. When I want to get lean, I cut back the carbohydrates. Before competition, I cut back carbohydrates. Then you eat a lot of carbohydrates for 3 days, and it drains the water out from under the skin, and the veins pop out. These are the tricks.
The secrets.
But it's healthy eating. No alcohol, by the way. It's interesting that bodybuilders don't drink alcohol. And I asked Atkins this about 12 years ago. I said, Bob, why can't I have a few scotches every night? There's no carbs in scotch,
right?
No carbohydrates in scotch. He said, because your body will burn the alcohol before it burns the glucose. Uh-huh. So if you're trying to lose body fat, you're putting another step in between the fat burning process. With that, I stopped drinking. And it's very interesting to me, because you never see serious bodybuilders drinking alcohol. For that reason, because they always want to be lean, unless, you know, when they're not competing, but they want to get lean, and to get lean, you can't drink alcohol.
Tell us a couple of the secrets. I'm sure a lot of people out there want to know about dropping body fat, and there's a lot of misconceptions around hormones, in particular the male hormone and the female hormone. Can you talk very simply about some of those secrets that you've learned?
Well, what happens, you know, with young people, if they want to drop body fat, all they have to do is just eat a few fewer carbs, do a bit of exercise, do some cardio, and they're going to lose weight. If you get people who are starting to get older, over 50, for example, if you've got overweight men, an overweight man of over 50, typically his testosterone, the male hormone, changes over, aromatizes into a female hormone, which makes it harder for him to lose weight, and he'll get more fat. So my suggestion would be, with men over 50, firstly, you shouldn't be overweight. If you're going to get overweight, it's going to affect your libido, it's going to affect your health badly. And what you might want to do is see a knowledgeable doctor who knows about hormones to measure your blood. The most important is to get your blood levels tested, not to do things on your own. Get your blood levels tested, let the doctor advise you. It could be that a male might need replenishment of testosterone as he gets older. Some women need estrogen, but you need a doctor to advise you, a qualified doctor who understands hormones.
And on that note, we're in Phuket. It's a beautiful place. There's lots of spas here, lots of cleansing clinics, lots of superfoods. I'm sure you have some special foods that you eat every day. Can you mention some of those to us?
Well, you know, I happen to be staying with Guru Nalbani, and he has vegetable juice every day, twice a day, which is super, super healthy. I mean, you can't beat that, raw vegetable juice. And of course, we both love lots of raw vegetables, so that's super healthy, and I think you can get very good vegetables here. Phuket reminds me of California in a way. It's a healthy lifestyle. You've got lots of sunshine, so people tend to be healthier.
And is there any supplements that people could get locally? I know we spoke about things like spirulina to purify the blood and things like that. Is there anything you take?
I'm sure. I take chlorella, which purifies the blood. I take multivitamins. I think everyone should take D3, which is really a hormone. They call it vitamin D3, but it's very, very important to take. Fish oil, good quality fish oil. These are the basic supplements that I take that most people should take if they're going to start taking supplements. But a good quality multivitamin is very important. And by good quality, I mean not one a day. One a day is too compressed. It doesn't contain enough, so it doesn't do much good.
Okay, well, it's a pleasure to have you on the show and here with Classic Media and Phuket News, and hopefully we'll see you training in the club and enjoy Phuket.
I love coming here. This is a great place. It's my second visit, and the gym is superb. The people are nice. What more can one want? The weather's great. It's terrific. I'll be back.
Thank you.
Thank you.